magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. We bring you greetings from God's Miracle Ministry for Deliverance, where the founder is God. We are excited about you tuning in, and with this word from God, you will be empowered, you will be strengthened, and your atmosphere will be changed. Sunday morning worship is at 9 a.m. Tuesday night prayer and Bible study is at 7 p.m. Our current location is 2116 Pear Street in Greensboro, North Carolina, under the leadership of Pastor Jacqueline and Elder Bobby Bynum. So get ready to receive your miracle and your breakthrough as you hear and receive today's powerful word.
Amen. I will be reading a little bit this morning and feeling the presence of God, amen, in this place. Amen. Certainly, in order we do honor God in his presence, amen, and for his goodness and his mercy. Let me honor Elder Bynum, amen, and to Associate Pastor Taylor, amen, to Minister Grimes, and to Prophetess Grimes, amen, to the Missionary Board, amen, amen, to Minister in Training, Minister Wilkins, and Minister in Training, Minister Harrison. We do honor them as well today. Amen. We see that God has a vision that is beyond us, and so we want to follow him forward. I don't know what y'all gonna do, but I'm gonna follow him forward. Amen. I'm not gonna look to the past, amen, but I'm going to follow him forward. Amen. The 20th chapter of the book of Chronicles, the second Chronicles. And I may just start reading the first verse, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you would bless this thou, our word, to get into our spirit. Amen. You can be seated, Sister Joyce. That'll be fine. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah.
How many people know the devil is a liar? The devil is a liar. And you're already healed in the name of Jesus. Already healed in Jesus' name. See why what other folks is playing, amen, and faking and laying at home, amen. We got some praying to do, amen. Hallelujah. Because we coming out. Hallelujah. Coming out, coming out, coming out, coming out. Say it with me. Coming out, coming out. Coming out, coming out, coming out, coming out. Coming out. Amen. 20th chapter, first chapter, first verse of the 20th chapter. It came to pass after this also that the children of Moab and the children of Ammon with bear them other beside the Amorites came against Jehoshaphat to battle. Then there came some that told Jehoshaphat, saying, there cometh a great multitude against thee from beyond the sea of the side Syria. And behold, they be in Hazazon Tamar, which is in Gede. And Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaim a fast throughout all Judea. And Judea gathered themselves together to ask help of the Lord. Even out of all the cities of Judah, they came to seek the Lord. And Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court and said, O Lord God of our fathers, art not thou God in heaven, and rulest not thou over all kingdoms of the heathen? And in thine hand is there not power and might, so that none is able to withstand thee? Art thou our God, who didst drive out the inhabitants of this land before thy people Israel, and gavest it to the seed of Abraham, thy friend, forever? And they dwelt therein, and have built thee a sanctuary therein for thy name, saying, if when evil cometh upon us, as the word, as the sword, judgment, or pestilence, or famine, we stand before this house, and in thy presence, for thy name is this house, or thy name is in this house, and cry unto thee in our affliction, then thou wilt hear and help. And now behold, the children of Ammon, and Moab, and Mount Seir, whom thou wouldest not let Israel invade, when they came out of the land of Egypt, and they turned from them and destroyed them not, but behold, I'm sorry, behold, I say how they reward us to come to cast us out of thy possession, which thou hast given us to inherit. O our God, wilt thou not judge them? For they have not, no might against this great company that cometh against us, neither know we what to do, but our eyes are upon thee. Let's skip to the 20th verse. Sorry, 15. And he said, hearken unto ye, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat, thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude, for the battle is not yours, but God's.
Amen. Hallelujah.
20th verse. And they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness, Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God. So shall ye be established. Believe his prophets. So shall ye prosper. You can be seated right there. Just briefly. Just briefly.
Amen.
It has become quite apparent to me that sometimes the things that we go through, we are not just going through them alone. Sometimes there has been spirits sent against us to cause us harm.
Yes. Go ahead. Yes.
There have been wishful thinkings. People with evil presences have said things or wished things against you, or even tried to prophesy things against you, yes, to cause things to come against you that maybe you did not even cause on yourself.
Yes.
What I find is that people find that if you are doing well, they become jealous.
Yes.
They become infuriated by you because they're afraid that God is going to raise you up above where they are.
Yes. Yes.
And so what they do, they get other people to come on their side to come against them because they know that if you get a group against me, that's more than I can stand because I am one person.
Yes.
And what you got to understand is that, that sometimes that is God's will for that to happen, even though it does not feel good. It's not as bad when Sister Phyllis comes against me because it's just her. But if Sister Phyllis and the whole missionary board comes against me, that's a tough one right there. But sometimes people don't come against you until you're doing the will of God. But you got to understand that it's not the flesh of the people, but it is the evil spirit that has come against you. It's not the person, but it's an evil spirit. Come on, somebody say, an evil spirit. But tell somebody, the battle is not mine, it is the Lord's. What we got to understand is that even though these things have come against you, you still have to stay close to the Lord. You can't afford to walk away from God or just settle down or just accept that thing. You've got to get some type of strategy to come against that spirit. You can't just welcome that spirit in and sit down. You've got to get some kind of fight. And let me tell you how
situation and change things. The Bible says that he called a fast in the midst of the people. And I need you to understand, when you call a fast among the people, everybody may not fast, but you fast anyway. Everybody may not do what you say, but you go ahead and do it anyway. Why? Because the battle is not yours. It belongs to the Lord. King Jehovah back called that fast. And all the people went on a fast. And they began to pray. And the Lord began to speak to them. And he told him, he said, the battle is not yours. It belongs to the Lord. And King Jehovah back got a group of people. And he came before the people. And he told the people, he said, let me tell you one thing. If you believe in God, you shall be established. Is anybody established today? Because you believe in God. You might not believe it, but just because I believe in God, I've got somewhere to live today. Just because I believe in God, I've got a good husband today. Just because I believe in God, all of my children are well today. Just because I believe in God, he's going to bring us out of every situation. Say yeah. Yeah. I can feel the Holy Ghost. Because what you got to understand is all the time, why you believe in God, everything don't always look right, but believe it anyway. Say yeah. 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 And the Bible says that he let them know that God is establishing us. And you may not believe it, but God is establishing you right now. He's putting you together with the right people for the right time. Because the battle is not yours. It belongs to the Lord. You might not believe it, but the things that you're seeing now is establishing you. It's establishing you in the spirit, man. It's establishing you on your job. It's establishing you in your family. It's establishing you in your church. Say it. God, I need you to establish me in a time like now. Does anybody need God to establish you? What do you mean, prophet? Establish me so I can grow in the word. Establish me so I can grow in the spirit. Establish me so I can prophesy. Establish me so I can keep my joy. Establish me. Tell your neighbor, I know it don't look like it, but I'm being established right now. I know that I'm going through, but I'm being established right now. When the prophet speaks, I'm getting ready to prosper. I'm getting ready to prosper. You know why? Because I believe everything that the prophet says. The Bible says that when you believe the prophet, you shall prosper. Somebody need to say it. People don't say it because they don't believe it. Now believe in the prophets. So I'm getting ready to prosper. I'm gonna prosper in my money. I'm gonna prosper in my health. I'm gonna prosper in my mind. I'm gonna prosper in my walk. I'm gonna prosper. Yeah, yeah. And the Bible say, good God Almighty, they obey the man of God. Yes, he did. Not in obeying the man of God. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. When they got to the top of the cliff of the hill, they began to praise the name of the Lord and sing song. Lord have mercy. I dare you to be going through and sing a song. Lord have mercy. Who was that group that said, sing a song? Sing a song. Sing a song. You'll heal your body. Sing a song. You'll give you a job. Sing a song. Come on, somebody. Say more. It takes a team. More.
Prayers to you and your family. This is your season. Sunday morning worship is at 9 a.m. Tuesday night prayer and Bible study is at 7 p.m. Our current location is 2116 Pear Street in Greensboro, North Carolina, under the leadership of Pastor Jacqueline and Elder Bobby Bynum.